why do I say that climate change is a public health emergency? It's a little bit technical, but bear with me here. I put it all on this slide just so I wouldn't forget the points. But the technical part is that the climate system, changes in the climate system that have occurred, that we have engineered through human activity over the past 200 years, largely through our choices of fuels, burning of fossil fuels, but also through deforesting large parts of the earth, those changes in the climate system have inertia. Yesterday's actions will continue to play out, not just today, but they will continue to play out for the next many generations. So we've already baked into the climate system pretty close to 1.5 degrees centigrade of continued warming, or excuse me, a warming total. And nothing we can do about that. Humanity's current goal, as expressed in 2015 through the Paris Climate Agreement, is to limit that global warming to no more than 2 degrees centigrade. The problem with that is after 2015, I believe it was 2018, the IPCC released in a special report called their 1.5 degree report. They released a report which made the case that 2 degrees of warming is not safe. 2 degrees of warming will cause profound harm to human health and well-being. And a better goal, the safer goal for humanity, would be to limit warming to 1.5 degrees. So we got a bit of bad news there, and we have a bit of worse news on top of that, which is that we, while the nations of the world, the US excluded, because President Trump has pulled us out of the Paris Climate Agreement, but all of the other nations of the world have agreed to limit the warming to 2 degrees, but the commitments that have been made to achieve that have been only 50% enough. In other words, if we had one of those thermometers that we see out in front of our local elementary school, the fundraising thermometers, and if we were to represent the commitments to the Paris Climate Agreement, that thermometer would only be at the 50% level. We still got to get the other 50% just to limit warming to 2 degrees. But if we don't get there soon, our more likely trajectory is that we will have global warming of more like 4 or 5 degrees. And as fellow public health professionals, I would contend to you that failure is not an option.